Hello, I'm Kimberly.
And I'm Rebecca.
And this is the Loki Lego Launcher 2.0, the second spacecraft in the Young Stuff Space Program.
Last fall, we built and launched our first spacecraft, which went up to 78,000 feet.
For 2.0, we reused the same spacecraft, but this time with a few modifications.
First, we got a bigger balloon, which of course meant more helium.
Second, we added an APRS radio tracker, which sent us location and altitude data in almost real time.
We already have a GPS tracker on board, but that doesn't work above a certain altitude. Plus, it can't transmit data to us. However, the APRS might not be very accurate at ground level, so having the GPS unit as well is very helpful.
Third, we conducted a solar experiment on board with a solar panel and a voltage/current sensor to test our hypothesis that we would be able to produce more current as we moved higher through the atmosphere. Our new sensor, which we were beta testing for high altitude science, tracks voltage, current, and power.
It took us a long time to figure out how to wire the sensor and the solar panel in a way that would make sense. We learned a lot about wiring things in series and in parallel by doing lots and lots of tests, mostly by using trial and error. But we figured it out eventually. For our launch crew this time, we have a picture of our late cat Loki and also a Lego minifigure of Rey, an important character in the new Star Wars movie, who inspired us because she's strong, smart, and brave.
We planned our launch site by looking for a place where we predicted our spacecraft was unlikely to land on someone's head or cause any damage. We drove out to Central Washington and got ready for our launch. This time, we were also providing live updates on our blog.
It was exciting for us because it was amazing to see how big the balloon got. We also had put in a lot of time preparing for the launch, so with all our anticipation, we could definitely feel the adrenaline going.
Our flight computer keeps track of a number of things, including altitude, latitude, longitude, speed, temperature, pressure, voltage, current, and power. There is a lot of data that we can learn from. This time, our APRS radio tracker was sending us some data in real time, which was really awesome.
Soon, it was time for launch. Temperature data was really similar between this launch and our first one, which is a good thing, because we don't think the atmosphere has changed that much. One of our goals was to have our Loki Lego Launcher go higher than 90,200 feet. We were super excited to find out that it went all the way up to over 101,000 feet. The images our camera took from up there were really awesome.
Our current data was really interesting because when you draw a trend line through our graph, you can clearly see that our solar panel was producing more current as the altitude was going up, which indicated that our hypothesis was correct. Once it reached apogee, or the highest point, our balloon burst and our spacecraft started falling back to Earth. It took 53 minutes to fall to the ground where we were waiting for it. And I made some funny noises along the way.
Listen above to the words some kind of sign. If you wanna be free, be free. If you wanna stay clear, I can be until you leave. If it's here, that's what I'm finding.
Our GPS data showed that it landed in an open field and tall grass. It took us a little while to find it, but thanks to our GPS, we weren't wandering around lost, even though we were super excited.
We learned a few lessons from this launch. Redundant systems are very useful. Having our APRS tracker as well as our GPS tracker gave us much more confidence that we were going to be able to recover our spacecraft.
Experience makes a difference. Having done this before meant that we had previous knowledge and data to compare to and fall back on. There were a lot fewer unknowns the second time around.
And also, having fun as a family is the best. We love doing experiments together and spending time learning as a family.
Thanks for watching our Loki Lego Launcher 2.0 video. We enjoyed sharing our launch with you, and feel free to check out more details on our blog.
Bye!
Thanks for watching!